As Hart continues to play Navy hockey, the Sabres shoot it down the ice. That will be icing, and we've got Schultz behind the Sabre net with Schoenfeld.
Schultz drives Schoenfeld into the far corner to our left, trying to get the right hand free. Schoenfeld pumps the right. Pretty much a wrestling match. Now Schoenfeld grabs the back of Schultz's hair. They're still wrestling in that far corner to our left. Now Schoenfeld has Schultz with his back to the boards. Schultz trying to turn him around again. Thus far, no punches of any magnitude landed by either player. And very quickly now, seeing that probably none will be landed, Neil Armstrong trying to wedge his way in between. Claude Béchard is in there. Wally Harris standing on the perimeter. They have not parted yet. Schultz now paws the left hand, and finally they are parted, as Schoenfeld got a token left hand in as they broke. Now Dudley and Goodenough. Now Dudley and Kelly have a hold of each other. Dudley and Kelly.
And Dudley, of course, was the madman last year in the National Lacrosse League. And he's got a tough opponent there. There they go. Left and right, left and right. They're up. Another left by Kelly. A right by Dudley. A left and a right by Kelly. Left and right. They're just pumping it away at each other. Down goes Kelly again with Dudley on top. Kelly is grabbed and Dudley puts it down. Now we've got Harris and Ramsey having a little go just to their left. And now they tie up against the glass, and that was a good one. Harris and Ramsey, and now Kelly have been separated by the two linesmen, and Goodenough with loose at center ice. Now they've been separated. So we're going to have a series of major penalties. The first 5-minute majors for fighting in the set. We played through three games in this period, 10 periods with only one misconduct. And Dudley is full of blood, and I don't know whether it's his own or whether it's Bob Kelly's, but the whole left side of his shirt is covered with blood. And we'll see in a moment. And it looks like Dudley was the one that was cut badly. Let's see. Schultz is looking at Kelly in the box. Kelly puts the up to his nose. There's a lot of blood there, and I don't know to whom it belongs. But all that started with Harris dumping it into the corner. The Sabres took it, fired it down the ice, and while the icing was called, Schoenfeld and Schultz went at it, and then Dudley and Kelly. And I guess you'd have to say pretty much a standoff.
Yeah, they both got in some pretty good shots. As we look at some replay, and now the penalty is being at us.
5 minutes for fighting.
Schultz gets five for fighting. And we'll fill you in on the rest of the penalties. 14:22 left in second period action. It's 2-1 Flyers. So we end up with 4 5-minute fighting majors, 2 to either side. Schultz and Kelly for the Flyers, Dudley and Schoenfeld, or Schoenfeld and Dudley if you work from left to right in the boxes. We look from up here across the way.
Good shot. The Selesky just throws it off the corner boards. Here's Schultz's left shot. Sharp angle, score! From a sharp angle along the blue line, DeGuard had misplayed it, and it went in off the back of his body into the net. 1-0 Philadelphia.
Tim, that puck hit something on the ice. It was going right along the ice and bounced up into the corner. I wonder whether we'll see it or whether it was deflected, but it did change direction. Maybe Kinderchuk might have gotten his stick on it. We'll take another look at it from a different angle. We'll just see the shot by Schultz. The puck is going along the ice and it bounced. It might have hit the Buffalo defenseman stick, but it didn't.
DeGuard obviously didn't see the puck. It looked like he was looking for it low and it's up behind him off his back. So to the open man, Bill Height broke that up. Goodenough has it back again. Stanfield checking in. Gets it to Kinderchuk. Spencer on him at the Flyer line. Ted Harris. Good enough. Good pass for Schultz to get alone. Score! Schultz! The second goal of the game from the rookie Larry Goodenough, and it is 5-0 Philadelphia. That was bad back checking. I think that's Jim Lorenz's fault. He wasn't back checking properly on that guy.
Watch both defensemen get caught up here. He gets behind them. Well, this happened a couple of times in Buffalo on Thursday night.
He makes a good play. All that, Schultz makes an excellent play on that ball.
Let's take a look at Schultz on that isolation. He anticipates this. We'll see him waiting in behind that defense right here. And Lorenz, as you mentioned, didn't let him get away, Phil.
Yeah, he just outskated Lorenzen. He got around Bill Hutton.
The Flyers have won the second in a row. The Flyers have won their second consecutive Stanley Cup. And the whole Flyers bench is off the ice. I'll tell you, they fought from adversity when they had to, and they were the big ones when they had to. And Bernie Perrin was big tonight when he had to. Mike Nicolak and Fred Giroux on the ice. And the traditional handshake will take place. The carpet has been rolled out in the Buffalo end of the ice as they will announce, I believe, the Conn Smythe Trophy winner. Gene Hart is down there. I can see him from here. And the congratulatory handshakes between these two clubs, the two finalists, and what a final this has been. Look at the similarity between last year and this. Last year, the Flyers beat Atlanta in four straight. They beat them in the fourth game in overtime. They beat Toronto this year, four straight. They won the fourth in overtime. They went seven to beat the Rangers last year. They went seven to beat the Islanders this year. They went six to beat Boston last year. They went six to beat the Sabres this year. The script has been repeated, and the Flyers are the first team in 6 years to win two consecutive Stanley Cups, the first American-based team in 20 years to win two in a row. Bill Clement, the insurance goal, the game winner from Bob Kelly. There's Dave Schultz, Bernie Perrin, going through the line. And I'll tell you, it's been a rough series for him. He knew he was in a series with a bunch of pretty good shooters. Clarence Campbell with the Stanley Cup, and their traditional skate will take place as it has since the cup was first awarded. Here's the announcement. And I'm surprised at these Buffalo fans booing the Flyers on the announcement of the presentation of the cup. It'll be Bobby Clark hoisting the cup to his shoulders. Oh, this has been some kind of night, I'll tell you. The picture taking is going on now, and that will be completed before Bobby hoists the cup to his shoulders. We'll see if Perrin will join him as he did last year. Hey, don't go away, friends, because we're going downstairs. Here's the Conn Smythe, the winner. Bernie Perrin wins it the second year in a row. The most valuable player in the playoffs, Bernie Perrin, who tonight, to nail down the Stanley Cup, came up with his fourth playoff shutout of the year. We're going to be going downstairs after the festivities on the ice for a post-game victory celebration. So don't go away. We've got lots coming your way. They're still taking pictures. Terry Crisp, who didn't address tonight, is out there. And he played a big part in this victory. Dornhofer realized his dream of playing member of a Stanley Cup champion. And there's Bernie and Bobby Clark with the traditional skate with the Stanley Cup. And now the Sabres fans cheer. Trailed by the entire Flyer Club, they'll make it once around the Buffalo ice before returning it to their dressing room. Perrin and Clark with the cup hoisted aloft. And there's that clenched fist of Bobby Clark saying, attaboy, gang, we did it again. And they'll head for the Flyers dressing room, as will the entire Flyers group, as Clark two-handed raises it to the shoulder, and they head for the dressing room. And so the game is over. The final score, the series is over. The final score, 2-0. And again, for the third time, we'll be going downstairs for a post-game victory celebration. So don't go away. Oh.